As the House went on short recess on 31st of October 2023, it had three pending bills, including the Animal Feeds Bill 2023, the Explosives Bill 2023, and the National Legal Aid Bill 2022, all under scrutiny before relevant committees. 11 petitions were pending disposal, 2 accountability reports, and 17 other business in progress in other committees. While sending Parliament on short recess, the Deputy Speaker Thomas Taiyebwa cited gaps in the House committee business, emphasizing lack of coordination between sectoral committees and accountability committees, which is making it difficult for Parliament to perform its oversight function. In that regard, he sent all committees to the field.
The committees, sectoral committees and standing committees, especially accountability committees, are not gelling together, are not working together to address issues of accountability. Because the accountability committee finds issues, raises recommendations, the House adopts, but the sectoral committee goes ahead to appropriate money to a sector where questions are clearly asked and nothing has been done.
While releasing their tentative program, which starts effective next week, different chairpersons welcomed the new arrangement, saying it was long overdue and it will go a long way in addressing accountability backlog.
Of course, it also involves logistics. They have to work with the clerks to prepare logistics for travels. And at the level of business committee, we have been able to identify the pending business in each committee.
So the Speaker of Parliament deemed it fit and necessary to send committees of Parliament to the field to clear the backlog on their desks for these 2 weeks to follow up on cases they have not handled or cases they have partly handled and come back and report.
The chairperson disclosed that they are heading into the budgeting season, which starts from December this year, and it is important to first establish how government is performing in the implementation of the current budget.
Like my committee that has to look at every local government in the country and looking at the public service sector, we are not going to cover every local government.
During the 2 weeks oversight lap, the chairpersons disclosed that they will interest themselves at the mess within the districts and the cities, especially in the docket of service commission.
Now, this time, this period we have been given, the committee will be going out in the field to look at three key areas. One, we are going to be looking at the functionality of the district and city service commissions.
The chairpersons also highlighted the continuous outcries involving salary disputes, recruitments, bribery in local governments, and they believe it is time to dig deep into the financial management of different districts.
Every committee has a mandate, and it is according to different sectors and programs. So each program is very important. So every committee has got important business.
In the third session of Parliament, which runs between July to October, Parliament passed 12 bills, adopted 17 resolutions, adopted 22 reports, 36 ministerial statements, and concluded 2 petitions under the 40 sittings held. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.